All right, welcome back to the channel, everybody. This is going to be my video on how to set up your blog inside of ClickFunnels 2.0. I have not even tried to set this up yet, so this is going to be a raw, real, unfiltered, unedited video. This isn't going to be something polished up. You know, it may work. Maybe there's a bug. Maybe there's something that may stop me. Maybe, you know, everything goes smoothly as planned. We will see. Depending on when you're watching this video, as of right now, the software just released and finished their launch, but you may be watching it later and maybe it changes or maybe it still looks like this. Okay. Also, while I kind of go through this, I'm going to just sort of share some of my experiences with this launch, with the software. I mean, you could see that I haven't finished this setup, but I have played around in general in a lot of the different areas. So I'm going to give you my feedback and a lot of the stuff that I see the community talking about. But let's go ahead and dive right in with this. So it looks like we got some sample pages here. So I'm going to go ahead and click get started with your blog. Let's see what this looks like and what it says. All right. So this is the actual blog page where, like, I guess the posts are going to show up. All right. So that's pretty much the page. So we would need to just kind of come in here and play around a little bit in the editor. So of course we would want to change this picture here. I got some stuff and I do apologize. I'm a little bit under the weather, so I'm going to try not to cough in your ear on that. Now this is actually a universal section, so I'm going to go ahead and save that. I guess it's going to impact everything on every page. So we got that. Welcome to our blog. I guess I need to put some information here about me. So it says CEO of the best blog ever. I want to change that. Let's see here. The funnel man. That's cool. I need to write a little bitty, a piece of content about myself. Let me just change this picture real quick. I'll probably come back and change this later, but I got this one here. Let's see how that one looks. I got a couple of these cut off at different areas. I think this one here. Cool. All right. I need to put in a little bit of info about myself. I don't even really have a bio in the news to everybody. Like, try to like write a quick bio. It doesn't really need to be that long, but just write a quick bio. So I might say that, you know, I am a, can't type this morning. I'm trying to think at the same time. So I'm a digital biz player helping people create their dream digital business and avoid guru money sinks. I'll probably clean it up, but whatever. Let's get something in here, right? I'm going to go ahead and save that. I'm a chronic oversaver, by the way. And so what they do is they always have a lead magnet offer at the bottom. So that's pretty cool. So here's what I'm actually going to do. This is going to say, join the Digital Biz Players newsletter. And then I'm just going to tell them I write daily emails, sales funnels, digital business, digital marketing, and life as a suburban dad from the hood. Sometimes they help other people make money too. And then I'm just going to change my button here. Button is just going to say subscribe. Let's change that to subscribe. I can't type, y'all. And I like going through this because I'll be transparent, right? Like, we overthink a lot of this stuff and you want to get it right, but done is better than perfect. And so you see that you could literally just come in here and just start typing and go off with a cuff and keep it simple just to get something up and get it running. And so this is an exchange value for email headline. Let's see here. The interweb's most notorious digital hustler spills his daily tea. All right, whatever. That works for me. I'm not going to overthink it. I don't care. I'll probably come in later and change the background on that. But you kind of get it, right? So that this top part didn't save. That's weird. I'm not sure why that didn't save. I'm going to preview it just in case. Let's take a look and see if that did. Okay, so it didn't save. So I'm not sure why that part didn't save. So let's go back in here. Let's edit universe. I don't know why that didn't save. So let's try it again. Not really sure what this is. Okay, I accidentally created a column, which I do not want. Okay, so let's go ahead and discard. Sometimes that's going to happen. I don't know if I did that. I don't know if the software did that. So let's try that again. The interwebs most note. Okay, so let's try to, okay, you know why I didn't hit save universal. That's why I hit save up there, but I didn't hit universal. So here we go. All right, let's take a quick preview at that. Okay, cool. So you can see here, I have to go in and edit this page, of course, for the bottom piece, but that's that. Okay, that looks cool. So some of my initial thoughts with this, right? Like if you're just starting out, I think this is in a good place and in a good spot for you. I do. Because you're going to be able to have everything that you need from a funnel hub standpoint, from the ability to be able to make funnels, to be able to email marketing, do all of that stuff right out of the gates in one software. The page load speed is as advertised. You all saw, I'm going to show you this again. I mean, look, this thing here is, I mean, that's lightning quick. So the page load speed is as advertised. You can see how fast the editor moves when you click that. I mean, that's really, really quick as far as how that's concerned. Super, super fast stuff. So all of that stuff is very good. There are some bugs and glitches, obviously, because of course it is a beta. And I'm going to say beta in quotation marks, just because we all, if you've been around the block, you know that beta means make money now, fulfill later. So it is in quote unquote beta. But again, some of this stuff should have already been taken care of. And so there is some head scratching things. But if you're just beginning, I don't think you're going to notice that. But if you, for example, already have a list, you cannot import a list, right? So all of your contacts that are in ClickFunnels 1.0 or ActiveCampaign or, you know, whatever, or even if you buy data, you can't import your list. I'm just clicking around right here. So I'm looking at the blog post, and I don't know if this is a sample post or if this is real or not, because this page is grayed out. And then let's see, getting started with your blog. So I don't really know how that works. Okay, I see blog post template. Okay, I'm just going to type in here. Now, it's not August 4th, though, so I'm not really sure why that says August 4th. So I'm going to go back. But as I was saying, you can't import your contacts. And so since you can't import your contacts, what that means is that the only way that you can get your leads and your contacts inside of ClickFunnels is to manually do that yourself. And so what are you going to do? Are you going to pay somebody to manually do that? Are you going to do that yourself? Are you going to have to wait until somebody makes a third-party software and then charges you hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars? Hold on. This says, Dwayne, you've made it. On this page, you'll be able to create stylish blog posts. You ready? Yeah, I'm ready. Cool. So it's going to actually walk us through. Let's see what it says here. You can edit your blog's homepage and category templates by clicking on them, as well as adding new blog posts by clicking the plus button. All right. So I could have did that here. All right. Cool. First, you need to fill in your post details. Please remember SEO and sharing options are really important to get your blog post indexed. That's cool. We're going to go into the draft or the public section. That looks cool too. Okay, this is where we're going to be able to add me as the author, categories, and add any tags to get started. That's pretty cool. So let's go ahead and put my name in here. I don't have any. Let's see here. So I'm going to make a new category. This category is going to be called sales funnels. I wrote down categories that I'm going to be talking about in my content somewhere else, but I don't have it handy. So that was done. I don't know. It says that was created, but I don't see it there right away. I also don't see myself. So I guess I need to do this. All right. Bear with me while I put that in there. Oh, pick an image. Interesting that you can pick an image, but you can't see which one it is. So that's very, very interesting. So I'm just going to go with that. And hopefully that's it. It says it should not contain a symbol. Oh, that's true. That's true. Sorry, I forgot my email. Isn't that weird? Okay, so that's that part. So I should be here as an author. Oh, it says you got to start typing. So I'm typing and I don't see myself pop up. So I'm going to go ahead and refresh. Let's see if, now that I've refreshed. Okay. So I just had to refresh there. So I got to do that. All right. Cool, cool, cool. But yeah, so as I was saying, I'm going to go ahead and get that post ready. So as I was saying, not being able to import your contacts is a big deal, especially if you're already running a business. And so that's kind of a big deal. And the other thing is the fact that you cannot import funnels. And so since you cannot import funnels, that's all of the work that you did in ClickFunnels 1.0. Like what are you supposed to do now? Since you can't, well, I know that there is one software right now, and that software is like $497. And what you can do is that you buy that software, and then in one click, it imports all of your funnels from ClickFunnels 1.0 into ClickFunnels 2.0. But so you got to pay $500 to do that, or hire somebody to do it, or do it yourself. I mean, those aren't great options, especially when you consider that there are softwares out there already that will allow you to import pages that you, sales pages and funnel pages that you don't even own, that aren't even your personal property, into your account. And so the fact that ClickFunnels doesn't allow you to do that is very, very interesting. But all right, hopefully you all saw what I did there on this page as we were kind of walking through that. So I went ahead and I just found that section. So that's one of the things that I do like about this, is that there are a lot of pre-made sections that allow you to just kind of quickly and easily build these pieces out. So that's very, very cool. Here's something that has been just grinding my gears, man. This bar, the placement of this bar when you're working inside of the editor, it just makes no sense. Like for some reason, it literally always pops up in the wrong place and it just blocks you from trying to do stuff. I don't understand where that came from, who set that up that way. It's just super annoying. So yeah, I mean, that's a gripe. Overall, I like the editor. I don't know what that error is that keeps popping up in the bottom. You see it, right? Just like I do. I don't know what that means. Typically, it doesn't actually impede me from doing anything. But, you know, I do see errors popping up consistently when I'm working inside of the editor. But again, they don't seem to be stopping me. So I'm totally fine with that. But obviously, there's something going on there. But outside of that, right, the editor overall, really fast, really good. This bar, man, is just annoying. It's just always in the wrong place. Don't know why. And then you can't really move it around. So if anybody from the ClickFunnels dev team ends up watching this video, like, hey, it'd be nice if like this thing could move around. Just get it out of the way. Okay. So anyways, I'm just going to go through and kind of, I would say, copy-tize this blog. And what I mean by that is set it up in a way that it looks like a sales page. So that means short sentences, occasional four lines here, but ideally only two, separated by, you know, periods and triple dots. And so we do that just to make it easy. Da, 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 da. And so for the people that are writing daily email, one of the cool things that you could do is occasionally put your daily email as a post. That's super effective. I've seen a lot of people doing that. It's what I'm actually doing here. Obviously, if you're trying to do SEO and all of that stuff, you got to be more conscious of word count, SEO, and the like, and all of those deals. But for this purpose and demonstration here, I'm not really worried about SEO on this particular article. I just wanted to actually get in here and test this out, see what it looks like, see how this thing is just in the wrong place. And there's really nothing, there's nothing I could do about it. I can't move it. So I'm kind of just sort of at the mercy here of whatever's going on with this thing. I don't want to let people. And so again, whoever is at ClickFunnels, man, like I I just don't understand what the line of thinking was behind this bar and its placement. It's just always in an inconvenient spot. I don't know why. But I digress. I'm not going to beat a dead horse. But you see it for yourself. This blog, so this image actually will come from the information that's already there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and delete these. I'm actually going to add a call to action, just saying for more, but it does. This is gives you kind of fighting inside of the digital business player community. Let's see here. But this gives you a little glimpse. I'm going to change that. I share daily in my newsletter. I guess I have to put a link there. And this is actually, I think this is actually pretty cool. I like this because what you can do is I can either A, put like a link there. That's interesting. I could put an author. Huh. Interesting. I'm wondering if they have a button. So let's see here, blog posts. Here we go, button. Cool. This is actually something that I see Motley Fool do with their Fool blogs. They just have a massive network of writers. And then at the end, they always like offer you like a free tip. Let's get this stuff. Let's see here. I don't have this made yet. I'll probably just have to make it when I put this live, but whatever. I'm going to make myself accountable, right? So get a free. Let's see here. Let's see. I don't know. I'll probably change it to like a list building guide or something, but whatever. And then I'm going to have to delete this. This thing's going to be in the way again. And then let's see. We're going to just say what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to go to fool.com and let me see how they end their articles. And so if you haven't been to fool.com, you definitely want to check it out if you plan on like using the blog. I think that they're easily the best in the space at this. Now, again, the company is the Motley Fool, but their website is fool.com. It's for investors and they hire an insane amount of writers. I have no idea. I mean, literally they publish 30, 40 articles a day. It's insane. But at the end of every article, there is a pretty cool call to action. And so it'll say something like, should you invest $100,000? Like I'm looking at the end of one of the articles now, right? Like, hey, should you invest $100,000 right now? Before you consider, you'll want to hear this. Our analysts just revealed 10 stocks. See the 10 stocks. And then you click that button and it takes you to a landing page. I kind of like that idea. So what I'm thinking is we're going to need if I'm going to kind of do what they did, I need to put a sub headline. And so that sub headline would say something like, should you start a digital business right now? And then I'll put here, I may do a quiz or maybe a guide or something right there. So maybe we could say, maybe I'll do a quiz, take the quiz. I do need to do a small little thing here. So I'll need to do a small paragraph. Now, one thing that I want to be conscious of is that this is left aligned on their page. And one of the cool things about the editors, I love this style. Now, when you go in here, I'm going to show you this real quick and hit edit style. Like this changes things globally. And so it is so cool to be able to change this globally and all of the fonts and everything else. And when you make those changes, you just go click one button. Now, I haven't really changed this because I think this looks totally cool and this is fine for me, but you can see they got subheadline fonts, content fonts, all that stuff. Your base font size automatically scale. Like the editor is top notch. Like you're not gonna beat the editor. The editor is just, I'm just gonna show you how this looks. Like you won't get a complaint from me about the editor at all. I mean, this is just awesome. Like the editor's actually fun to come in here and like play around with. Like it is actually fun. So here's what I'm gonna do. Like you can see like how it just changes that. So that's pretty cool. The only thing that I'm thinking about is how they did this.
If I want this to go over some, how do I want that to look? Is that how it was? See, that's the cool thing too. Like, if you don't know how something was, you could just hit this button, right? And then it'll start changing stuff. So I went back to that point. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back to extra large. I'm totally fine with that. And see if, like, if you're confused and you're saying, well, what is this? So I can come to this paragraph. Now you could see that on this one, they've actually done their own, you know, typography and style here. So families enter. They did it totally different. If you ever want to change the style, you can just, I believe, click this button or whatever, something like that, I think. See how I clicked that and now it defaulted it back to my normal style. So then I just make it small. And then now that aligns with the style of everything else. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here, then I'm going to hit small, and then now it aligns. The only difference is that this is off-white or, excuse me, like a light gray tone. And then the other one is darker. So I guess I'll just copy this for now, 4A, 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 right? And then I'll just come in here and paste over. And we'll go ahead and let's see, I'm going to type in this. I'm going to left align it. And then basically they ask a bunch of questions. And let's just say here, before you consider starting a digital business, I might just say what funnel, you know what? Let's change this to, should you launch a funnel right now? Before you consider launching a funnel, you'll want to hear this. That's just what Fool says, right? And so this is where you do it. Just revealed what I believe to be the 5 most critical questions that a digital entrepreneur, I don't know how to spell y'all, don't judge me, should answer before they start the, I won't say grueling process of building a funnel. All right, cool. I'm just reading what they said. Let me see here. Let's see what those 5 questions are and answer them for yourself. Click the button below to get the worksheet for free. All right, cool. That looks pretty neat. So I'm going to go ahead and save it. And so this has been actually pretty smooth. So this is desktop only. I guess let me go ahead and slap another one of my pictures in. I could play with that, but that's fine. Title of this column. Let's just go with, let's do something fun here. DG Hustler. All right, let's do something fun here like Dwayne K. Gaddis 2, a.k.a. Funnel Man, a.k.a. DG Hustle. Let's have some fun. So let's see, the interwebs. Man, I do struggle with spelling. I'm going to keep saying that. Spell check is my friend. The interwebs, Mr. Tourist. Suburban Dad is back to his usual antics. Uncut truth on the digital marketing scene. All right, cool. Oh, see. All right, let's do it. I'm going to save. And then let's take a look. I feel like that was pretty smooth. Let's look at it. I don't have a picture. I guess I could whip one up in Canva. Okay, so that figure. Now, here's the thing. Why is it not showing here, even though I already filled it in as the author, right? It still says unpublished, even though I selected sales funnel. So I'm not really sure about that. Bad sales funnel blues, what a doozy. Okay, this is pretty cool. This is nice. I like it. I can dig that. This is pretty easy. That's pretty cool. I've never had a blog before, so I feel like really, really special about that. Now it's weird. See, it says unpublished there, but then the category does say sales funnel. So this actually worked out. That looks pretty neat. So let's do this. Let's click this hamburger. Let's look at blog home and see if that post is actually going to show up there. So nope, I see that. So I'm going to close this page. Now my, as you know, I see that info still there. So that looks cool. I see the categories. Okay, let's look at this page. So this says, welcome to our blog. I don't see anything. So, I mean, that's very interesting. Not really sure what's going on there, even though I do have this. Oh, maybe because this post isn't live yet. That's probably what it is. Okay. You know what we didn't do, though? We didn't take a look at mobile. Let's take a look at how they projected to look at mobile. And that's one of the cool things I will say about the style guide. What really makes us the style guide apart from like any other editor or builder is that the funnels look so much better when you actually look at them on mobile, and you have to do so much less mobile optimization with font sizes because you set that thing once for how you want it to look, and then it shows up there. So I just went back. Let's maybe edit this post. So this all looks good. This all looks pretty. Let's take a look at advanced settings. Nope, I'm not going to touch that. Not going to touch that. So we're not going to touch the advanced settings. Why don't we go into maybe Canva? I got another screen open. I'm going to look at Canva here real quick. And is there something for a blog post feature image? Okay, I'm seeing some stuff here for a feature image. I like it. So I'm just going to bring this over here where we can take a look at it. So I guess it's basically the same thing as a YouTube thumbnail. So, you know, I don't know. I'm just kind of looking to see if there's anything that really sticks out to me here. It would definitely be pretty much text only. I guess this one will have to do for now. So let's just change this to the bad. And there's somebody outside doing some lawn stuff. So excuse me for that. I'm going to just delete this, right? Oh, let's see here. Maybe. Nope. Let's try to move that up there. All right. So we go with the bad sales funnel blues here, right? I like Canva a lot, man. It's so easy to just like quickly whip up stuff. And obviously, because it's the blues, let's find a blue. Like, let's not overthink that. That's really the big thing. Like, you can spend all day overthinking stuff, and or you could just get in here and just start taking action. And that's one of the things that I like, and that's one of the things that I'm always in a constant state of trying to work on, right? Like, am I just taking action? Am I always moving forward? Am I not overthinking it? That is off-centered now that I tilt my head a little bit. But who cares, right? Let's keep moving forward. Let's keep moving forward. There's no need to overthink that. Let's just drag and drop this right in here. That did not work as intended. So we're going to have to select a file. That's fine. Yeah. Now we can drag it. But yeah, it's all about taking action, continuing to move forward. Let's go ahead and save and close that. I'm going to actually make this public, by the way, so we can see it on the other page. I should have did that already, but let's go ahead and look right here. So let's see. Bam. Oh. No, still no. It did show up on the other page. Isn't that weird? And I'm sorry, y'all. This says unpublished. I was tripping before. I thought it said tagged or whatever. This says unpublished. So I do apologize. I was tripping there. And I'm wondering if when I publish this, if my details are going to show up here. I don't know. We're going to find out right now, though. Let's go ahead and publish an article here and see what happens. So I'm going to go into settings and I'm going to go ahead and hit publish. And let's go ahead and see. We're going to hit save there. All right. So it says it was published successfully. Only post content can be edited on this page. Okay, cool. I'm cool with that. That's fine with me. All right. So let's go ahead. Bam. So that does come up there. That looks really good. Okay. So that looks pretty cool. And it has the date. You see the date there. That's neat, man. That's pretty cool. So here's what I actually got to do, right? So blog home looks fine. Blog category. I think it's this page template that needs to be edited. I think that's what's happening. Yep. So, okay. So see, it's going to pull the post and all that stuff. And this is really cool, man. Like, I don't know what a lot of this stuff does, to be honest with you. I don't touch it because it's all wired to pull from different areas. So like, again, when you get in here, don't start messing with like post title and all this other stuff. It's going to pull it from somewhere else. Like, that's the really, really cool thing that I like a lot about it. So this is already done. So now what I'm going to do is I just need to come in here and add, you know, my details to this page, right? So I'm going to have to just say, hey, I'm doing Gaddis, right? And then we're going to go, we don't want to do that. See, the editor's so quick, man. Sometimes you're just clicking and stuff starts happening. Not really sure what happened there. That's something that's a little bit weird sometimes, like clicking in the type, but okay. All right, so let's just go AKA Phonoman, AKA DG Hustler. All right, I'm gonna just paste that same little body, that same little bio that I cooked up right there. I like it. Now, if I hit save, I'm pretty sure now we cooking. Let's see here. Okay, so that's going to be the sample page. That looks good to me. All right, let's go back. And now I think if we go to the blog home, let's see if we can get some magic. Let's see if we got some magic because I published that article. Hey, look at that. I like that. All right, obviously I got to change my colors around. But let's go ahead and hit read more. Quick, bam. Okay, there it is. The Bad Sauce Phono Blues, da 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 da. That's awesome. Wow. There you go, man. So wrote the first post, got the picture image uploaded, got my stuff uploaded. This is pretty cool. I just got to come in here and fix this universal section. Obviously get rid of this. Add my little details there. Add my little details here. I mean, obviously, look, Funnel Hubs, man, you could see that they are going to be a good amount of work. You know, you can get in here and start knocking stuff out, but obviously all of this stuff either has to be deleted or filled in, right? So there is some work to be done when it comes to finishing up my Funnel Hub. But hey, I was able to get a blog post posted in today. So my Funnel Hub's not live yet. It will be live soon. I got to actually get the main page going, but wanted to get in here and play around with the blog post. So there you have it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know in the comments below if you made it all the way till the end. Let's do code word hustle. And then that way people that see this video that didn't finish it, they'll be like, what does that even mean? Why do they all say hustle in the comments? So that's going to be the secret word of the day. And until next time, peace.